J の英語モチベーションブースター、楽しく続けてブレイクスル
ー。 Hello everyone、 こんにちは、 J こと早川浩二です。
Hello、 アシスタントの生見恵です。この番組は英語を学ぼうとしている方、 TOEIC などの英語テストを受験しようと思っている方に、英語を楽しく続けていけるコツをお伝えしていく番組です。J さん、今回もよろしくお願いします。
よろしくお願いします。
さあ、今回は、セブ島のインタビュー後編ですね。
はい、そうですね、はい、今回も桐原グローバルアカデミーのヘッドティーチャーライアンにインタビューしてきました。
はい、
で前回はこうセブ島って一体どういうところなのかっていうお話中心でしたけども、うん、まあ、今回はセブ島の授業の内容、はい、桐原グローバルアカデミーではどんなことをしているのかというお話を中心に伺ってきました。
おお、興味深い。お聞きください。
Ryan, thank you very much for joining us again.、
Mm-hmm.
What today I'd like to ask you about Kirihara Global Academy,、mm-hmm. which is KGA.、Mm-hmm. Could you tell us about KGA?
Kirihara Global Academy has actually two branches.、Mm-hmm. We have the city branch here, this is the main branch, and the other one is called the premium branch.、Mm-hmm. Both branches、offer similar courses, except that in the city branch, we offer group class.Group classes.
Yeah.
Yes. Classes are man-to-man, also、mm-hmm. known as one-on-one,、
yeah.
and it's a 50-minute English class.
50-minute. How long do you study?
You will be given 8 hours to study in a day. So you will have eight different teachers.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
So basically, you know, you will have to experience different pronunciation, different accent, different teaching style. So you'll get to, like, you know, to experience、mm-hmm. different experiences while you study here.
Yeah. What time does the class start?
It starts at 8 and we finish at 4:50 in the afternoon.、So that's a 50-minute and then 10-minute break, and then you will have to, you know, study again、mm-hmm. with different teacher.
Okay. So、every class is basically one-on-one.、
Mm-hmm.
And after 50 minutes,、would the students move to another room?
Yeah, you have to move to another room, or sometimes they stay in the lobby and, I mean, in the cafeteria and、mm-hmm. talk with teachers. Like that.
Yeah. Okay. And also the KGA's, feature is, it's like a studying abroad in a hotel.
Yes. This is a very nice setup. Like, you know,、mm-hmm. the school and the hotel is in one building.、
Yeah.
So the students don't get, you know, the hassle of moving out.To go to the hotel, because、mm-hmm. some schools actually, the school is in a different building and,、
yeah.
and the house is a different、mm-hmm. place. So it's like a hassle. So this is a very good setup that we offer both the house and, you know, and the school in one building.
Yeah. So like right after getting up in the morning,、mm-hmm. they go to the restaurant.
Yes.
In the hotel. And go back to the room and get the materials、mm-hmm. and go to the class.In the same hotel.
Yeah.
And after class, they go to the restaurant for dinner and go back to the room in the same hotel. Go to sleep.
Yes, yes. Basically, they don't have time. Like, they cannot waste time, you know, going out, transferring to other buildings.
Yeah, that's really, really good.、
Mm-hmm.
Now, you mentioned last time, but I'd like to ask you again, what kind of lessons do you have at KGA?
We actually, and the good thing in KGA,、mm-hmm. Kirihara Global Academy, is actually we have a very personalized curriculum.、
Mm-hmm.
When you come to us, you tell us what you want to learn,、
oh.
and then we will give it to you.、
Yeah.
Like, for example, if you want listening, reading, and then we will offer that to you.、Mm-hmm. It's very personalized. We have assessment on your first day.、
Mm-hmm.
But basically, we offer general English classes, like listening, reading, writing.And we offer business classes as well. Telephoning, meeting, presentation, negotiations, socialization, business emails,、mm-hmm. and business emails.
So basically,、the students can learn what they want to learn.
Yes, yes. Because we cannot force our curriculum to other students because this might not match the students' needs.
Right.
So we ask the student. Some of our students are short stay.、
Mm-hmm.
So we have to hit the target. He has to hit his target.、
Mm-hmm.
We have to ask him, what do you want to learn? And then we will provide it to you. Mm-hmm. So it's more on like a very personalized mm-hmm. approach. We have all the subjects. We have all the listening materials and everything, mm-hmm. but it's up to the students what mm-hmm. he wants to learn. So that now we can hit your target.
I see. So if they want to study TOEIC,
they can. Mm-hmm. Yes, yes. And we also offer TOEIC courses. It's personalized. The one that I made with you. And you're actually supporting us with that. So we offer TOEIC mm-hmm. and then we have Aiken classes also.
Aiken classes too.
We do. Yes, yes. So it depends on the student's needs. Mm-hmm. And in the near future, Kirihara Global Academy is actually going to introduce a new speaking program.
Oh, really?
That aims to, you know, speed up the ability of the students to speak.
Mm-hmm. So is it the intensive speaking course?
Yes, it's more on like that. Like, mm-hmm. you know, we cover different activities and we created a curriculum that will really speed up your mm-hmm. ability to speak mm-hmm. in a matter of like 1 week.
Wow, okay. What's the shortest stay for the program? Is it 1 week?
The shortest is actually 1 week. But I was very surprised that we had a student next week that she will only study for 2 days.
2 days?
She is actually a repeater, but she will only study for 2 days. And I was quite surprised. And this is the shortest I have ever, you know, in record, but usually 1 week.
Yeah. So after 2 days, is she going back to Japan?
I think so. Uh-huh. I've seen this schedule and it's only for 2 days, Friday and Saturday.
Uh-huh. That's interesting.
I was actually surprised, a bit surprised yesterday when I received the, but she will be staying for 2 days. Mm-hmm. A repeater. She's a repeater.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So how about the student ages? Is it the university student? For adults?
We accept, I don't know, from our students, we had experience to have university students mm-hmm. to adult learners, mm-hmm. but mostly they are seniors. I mean businessmen, mm-hmm. like government employees, bankers, some are lawyers, and then some are Japanese English teachers.
Oh.
They come here not to study English, mm-hmm. but they come here to learn how to teach English. Oh.
How to teach English.
So when they can speak English. But they are Japanese English teachers, mm-hmm. so they know grammar. They know a lot, but they come here because they want to learn how to teach English. So mm-hmm. they want to get techniques from teachers, Filipino teachers.
So mostly they are highly motivated.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So we teach them, we give them classes, so they will give the classes to us. Mm-hmm. We became the students. It's like that.
Oh, that's good. So then they can practice.
They can practice.
And teaching English in English.
Yes, yes, yes. And Filipino style, you know, how we do it in the classroom.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, now Japanese high schools, mm-hmm. There are some schools that teach English in English.
Okay.
So this is going to be a great opportunity for them to practice.
Yes.
So you have an 8-hour
class.
Mm-hmm. And what do students do outside the class? Do you have any activities or vacation activities?
We actually have graduation parties almost every Friday. Like, you know, our students are leaving after a week. Mm-hmm. So Friday night is a graduation party. Yeah. So the students go out in a restaurant and they are actually joined by teachers.
Mm.
So even during dinner time, they get to speak English because they are surrounded by Filipino teachers.
Yeah.
So yeah, these are some of the activities, and yeah, sometimes on weekends they go out, they go to the beach, mm-hmm. they go somewhere, and usually older women, not really old, but adult learners, like they ask some of the teachers, can you go with me to, mm-hmm. to the beach, and something like that, and teachers go with them
mm-hmm.
as well, not as teachers, but as friends, mm-hmm. as a family.
That's good. And also there's a big shopping center.
Yes. All around Cebu City, like you can find the biggest mall in the Philippines is in Cebu City.
Oh.
And it's the fourth biggest in the world.
Fourth biggest in the world?
Yes, it's in Cebu City.
Oh. What's the name of the mall?
SM Seaside. It's newly built shopping mall and it's beside the ocean. So you can see the beach.
Oh, it's really good.
Yes.
I've never been there, so
you should try. You should go and try.
Okay. So, is there any tendency for Japanese students who improve quickly?
The young learners are very quick to learn. To be really honest, like, you know, university students and those young professionals are very quick to learn, like, you know, because they studied at school. But for the adult learners, they basically don't have this chance to study English when they were younger. So they are not struggling, but they are having a little hard time, you know, understanding how English works, how the sentence has to be written.
Yeah.
So basically the young learners are very quick and fast because of their education.
And but even older learners can, you know, learn languages after trying hard.
Yes, basically. And then they enjoy. They are very interested. You know, our adult learners are very interested in learning English.
How about those who struggle to learn English? Is it low motivated learners or someone who are kind of reserved and hesitant to talk?
Yes, there are people like, you know, they struggle because, you know, they're very reserved. Like, they're not very open to like learning this and that. But the good thing is Filipino teachers are very, you know, they try their best to, you know, to offer English, to make English very likable subject. So we do our best to, you know, for the student to learn it. So, yeah, even the hardest situation or word, the student will be able to understand it.
So the education style is very different from Japanese, from Japan. We tend to study passively, just sitting in the class and teacher talk, and we listen and we take notes, take tests.
Yes,
we did it or we didn't make it.
But in here, you know, we always believe in the idea that learning by doing. So you have to do it for you to be able to know it. So in the classroom, though, the students are always given this experience. Mm-hmm. He has to do it. He has to do it to know it.
How much time do they need to get used to that environment?
The first week is kind of hard. Like, it's the first struggle because, you know, the weather is bad. You know, some students feel, you know, uncomfortable or sometimes. First week is kind of struggle, but the second week is actually okay. But for some, the first day is only the struggle. The second day is they feel comfortable already. So basically the first 2 to 3 days is, you know, they get to know each other. So this is a very critical, not critical, but this is the time we're in. The teachers are very careful in handling the students. Because these are the times that, you know, that the students might be confused culturally or about the English. There must be a lot of stress. So, you know, the first 3 days is critical.
So the first 3 days means 24 hours.
Yes. And then after that, you know, they feel comfortable and they just become home, feel at home already. Yeah,
because of your hospitality.
Somehow, yes.
Yeah, I think so. Okay. I heard 25% of your students, the one person out of four people, are coming back after a while, like the lady you were talking about before. Why do we think is that?
That's a very, you know, positive remark. But, you know, we call them repeaters. We call them repeaters. They must have liked what we offered. Like, you know, we always tell our teachers to do their best, you know. We always put in our mind that these students need us, you know, we have to give them what they deserve. So we always tell the teachers, you know, it's very hard. Our service is education. We cannot tell the defect of education. Samsung has a cell phone. If a cell phone is broken, you can have it fixed easily. But in our case, we offer education and then we cannot see how it is the student improved or something like that. But we always try our best to give our best. So these repeater students must have, you know, been given this kind of, you know, service. So that's why they come again and again, not just once, but twice or thrice.
I came to Cebu last year and I talked to a man. Like, I asked him, is this your first time? He said, no, this is the fourth time. Surprise. Yeah, he really liked the school.
Yes.
Yeah.
We must have done a good thing to the student, to students. Some of them are coming back. And they sometimes request, like, to have the same teachers. And as much as possible, we do that. I do that because I am also responsible for creating schedule, student schedule, mm-hmm. and giving teachers. Mm-hmm. So I have to make sure that those repeaters will be given much, not much attention. Everyone is given much attention, but the repeaters are, they have requests. Like, can I have the same teachers that I had before? Mm-hmm. So something like that.
Now, Ryan, what advice would you give to people who are not confident in their English skills?
For me, English skill is not the problem, but their confidence.
Confidence. Mm.
It's not, the English is always there, but the confidence is not present. Mm-hmm. What you have to do is, you know, to tell yourself why you have to do this. You always have to go back why you came. Mm-hmm. And before you go, you have to always remember why you came in the first place. Mm-hmm. So they have to set a goal. They have to set a goal.
Goal, yeah.
And then, you know, the teacher will help them reach that goal. Mm-hmm. English is just there. Work on your confidence. Mm-hmm. Maybe because they are afraid, you know, of making mistakes or something like that. They don't talk a lot because they might get mistakes. It's okay. Mm-hmm. It's normal.
Yeah.
It's natural. So, you know, work on your confidence.
Right. Yeah. That's probably one of the problems of the, not English education, but our education. Mm-hmm. We were taught from a very early age not to make mistakes.
Okay.
You know, when
that's
we make
sad.
Mistakes, then my parents, not only my parents, but anybody's parents would say, okay, you will be laughed at by everyone.
If you make mistakes. Yeah. Some kind of like, you know, maybe trauma to make mistakes.
Right. To make mistakes, we will usually choose not to do anything.
If
you don't do anything, then you won't fail.
Yes, won't less talk, less mistakes.
Right.
Okay. But, you know, they don't think that it works the same way here.
No.
You know, we have a very free education. Yeah. You come here, you just have to talk, mm-hmm. and you will be corrected. And these corrections are the things that will help you become a better speaker, become a better learner. So no, the students will not have to worry about his skills. Mm-hmm. He has to worry about his confidence.
Right.
Work on your confidence. Come here and we will help you.
Mm-hmm. Do you have someone in your mind that when he or she came to school for the first time and they're less confident, they didn't talk, but after a week, there was a huge jump
yes.
in confidence?
Actually, yes. We have a university student now. She is actually staying for 6 months.
6 months?
The first week was she was like crying and I want to go back mm-hmm. and she misses the family and everything. And, you know, but teachers are very comforting. Mm-hmm. We try to make her like, you know, we welcome here, we talk to her. And now she's very confident being here and she's okay. She talks now. Yeah. She goes out with teachers. She cried a lot the first week, mm-hmm. actually. And we comforted her. Mm. We assured her that, you know, it's okay to be here.
Oh,
because
so
we are here.
Almost a different person.
Now, yes. She talks to everyone now. She's very sweet to everyone. She's a university student and she's still our student now.
Uh-huh. So the last question.
Oh.
No, not really a question. but I think a lot of listeners mm-hmm. are interested in coming to Sydney.
Mm-hmm.
Could you give them a message to people who are interested in studying abroad in Cebu?
I think now is the best time that you come here. Because when you come to Cebu, you'll not just learn English, but you'll get to experience mm-hmm. Filipino culture and enjoy the beauty of Cebu City. Don't worry if you cannot speak English now yet. Because time will come that we will make you better and a better speaker. You don't have to worry coming here for your safety or anything, that you are going to miss your family or anything, because you come here and we will welcome you as a family. Mm-hmm. We will become friends. We will become your family here. You will surely feel at home.
Well, Ryan, thank you very much.
Mm-hmm.
Lastly, do you have any message in Japanese?
Sadly, not at the moment. I'm actually studying now, but
oh, really?
Maybe I cannot possibly mm-hmm. say a few words yet. But probably, yes. Before you come here, please please study phrases that are very useful, like maybe introducing yourself, and so that when you come here, it will be very easy, you know, to talk with other people.
Right, yeah.
Learn a few phrases and then use it here.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Next time I will be speaking in Japanese.
Oh, that's good. That's good. Yeah.
That's a promise. There's a next time.
Yeah. I'm looking forward to doing the interview in Japanese next time.
Oh.
次は日本語でお願いします。
Okay, I will try.
Okay. どうもありがとうございました。
どういたしまして。
英語で名言。続いては毎日配信している J さんの単語メールボキャブラリーブースターから著名人の名言を英語でご紹介いただきます。 J さん、今回の名言は、
はい、今回はウィリアム・シェイクスピア、まあ、シェイクスピアですね。
はい。
Soothe the action to the word, the word to the action. Soothe the action to the word, the word to the action.
おお、ワードとアクションが2回出てきました、
ね、はい。行動を言葉に合わせ、言葉を行動に合わせよ。
あ、大事。
そうですね、
はい、大事ですね。有言実行とはまた違いますかね。ま
あ、有言実行に近いですよね。あと言行一致ですかね、
うん、
どちらかというと。4文字熟語でいくのであれば、
はいはい、
言ったことと行動を合わせる、行動していることと言うことを合わせるっていう感じですよね、
はい、そうですね。私はどちらかというとできなさそうだなって思うことは言葉にしないようになってしまっていて、で言葉にしなければ、まあ、行動はまあ、しなくてもいいかなっていう、
まあそうですね、
どんどん後退してる感じになっちゃうんですけど。
今年の1文字覚えてますか？
え、
今年の1文字
はいはい、そうですね。
進むですか？
ですからまさしくこれはやんなきゃいけないですね。私は
後退じゃないですかね、前進ですからね。
はい、
はい、ぜひ。
ただそうですね、そう、なんかできなさそうだなって思った時に言葉にしないって決めちゃう自分がいるんですよね、はい、
ぜひ宣言していただいて。
そうですよね、できなさそうなことでも言葉にした方が、
はい、これ不思議と言葉にしたことって実現するんですよね、
はい、本当ですか、
はい、僕もこの仕事をしながら、これ絶対無理だろうって思われてもおかしくないようなことを言ってたんですけど、
はい、
結構実現してるんですよね。
例えば何ですか？
例えば DS のキャラクターになりたいって普通思わないですね。もうその2009年に、わあ、いつか DS のキャラクターになりたいな。で、なぜそう思ったかというと、僕が小学生の時にやっていたファミコンのソフトのに高橋名人の冒険島っていうのがあって、その高橋名人っていうのがあの実在するファミコンのなんかもこう名人みたいな感じの人なんですね、
はい、
その人がキャラクターになってファミコンの中に登場してるので、もう小学生ながら、うわすごいなこの高橋名人って、
うんうん、
それをふと思い出して、なんかキャラクターになりたいなって、ゲームのキャラクターじゃなくていいので、なんか DS のキャラクターになりたいなって思ったら、DS ソフト作りませんかみたいな話があって、でその時に僕はあのキャラクターで出たいんですけどって言ったら、ああいいですね、面白そうですね、じゃあやりましょうって出させてもらったんですよ。
そうなんですか、
はい、あの時にやっぱ言ってみるもんだなって思いましたよね。
わかりました、
はい、
言葉にします。
ぜひ、はい、J's
Topics。 さあこのコーナーでは J さんにまつわるあれこれをお話しいただきます。J さん、今回のトピックスは何でしょうか？
はい、今回はあの偶然の出会いって面白いなっていう話なんですけども、
はい、
あのちょうど去年ですね、もう僕が使ってるスマホの電源が全然持たなくなってしまって、
はい、
5分持たないっていう感じで
大丈夫ですか？
大丈夫じゃなかったんですよね。でモバイルバッテリーとつないでおかないとすぐに電源切れてしまうっていう状態になって、まあ、ギリギリまで頑張ったんですけど、
はい、
ちょっとこれは無理だなと思って、あの携帯ショップに買いに行ったんですよね、
はい、
で担当してくれてた人が、まあ、ちょっとこれ仮名にしておきますけど、仮名のリーさんっていう、まあ、韓国の方、うんで、で担当してくれて、で一番最初にあのスタッフのリーと申します、外国人スタッフなので ちょっと日本語おかしくなったらその時はお伝えくださいみたいに、ほんの最初に断って、それがすごい流暢だったので、もう全然問題ないですみたいなところから始まったんですね。
はいはい。じいさん、その韓国人の方は、はい、あのスタッフさん、アルバイトとかなんですか？
社員の方っておっしゃってましたね。で、うん、なんか新入社員として入って、でまずは携帯ショップで修行してから、
はい、
まあ、おそらく本社に戻るっていうふうに言っていたので、うん、アルバイトではなくて、まあ、社員の方ですね。は
い、そうなんですね。
はい、でいろいろ話をしていく中で、なんでこの仕事されてるんですかみたいなことを僕がこう聞いていったら、うんうん、いや実はあの韓国にいるときにこうイギリスに出張に行ったりして、サッカー選手に英語でインタビューしたりしてましたとかっていう話をして、なんか全然じゃ違うのに、じゃあ英語ペラペラなんですねって言ったら、あ、まあそうですね、でももともとベルギーに住んでいたのでフランス語の方が得意ですみたいな話をして、それを日本語でずっとやり取りしてるんですよね。
すごい
すごいなって、なんで韓国でこう就職しなかったんですかとか、いやそこまで優秀だったらもうそれこそサムソンとか入れるんじゃないですかって言ったんですね。あ、ちなみにトイックは何点ぐらいですかって聞いたら、4年前で930でしたみたいな感じで、
ほ
う、やっぱりすごいな、もうサムソンとかいけるんじゃないですかって、いや受けたんですけどねダメでしたとかって、
ダメなんですね、
だから日本に来ましたっていう、この話ってあの77回配信号の海外の英語事情で話した、
はい、
あのホテル、本当は韓国のホテルで働きたかったけど、
うんうん、
働けずに日本に来て働いているっていう韓国の方の話しましたけど、全く一緒だなって思いましたね。
本当そうですね。
も
う
その時にじゃあやっぱり日本で就職するよりも韓国で就職するのが大変なんですかって言ったら、もう絶対大変ですって言ってましたね。
あ、そうですよね。うん、そんなに喋れるのに、はい、いろんな言葉を喋れるのに就職できないっていうのが、
できないですもんね。だって韓国語、日本語、英語、フランス語ですからね。
すごいですよね。
そうですね、まあ、それでも、うん、そこまで優秀でも、
はい、
まあ、なかなか国内で働くのは難しいということですね。でこれ本当に普通に携帯買いに行っただけなんですけど もなんかそっちの方がすごい参考になりましたよね。
まあ、ジェイさんがインタビューしたのが良かったですよね。
はい、そうですね、そうですね、僕ついこうインタビューしちゃうんですよね。前もあのベッドを買いに行ったことがあって、はい、ベッド選びで90分でその後その人の話聞くので2時間ぐらいかかったことあります、ね。
本当ですか？何を聞いたんですか？
なんかその人もすごい優秀な方だったので、いろいろ聞いてたら、
はい、
いや実はこの会社には尊敬できる人が一人だけいるっていう話をして、どの方ですかって言ったら、あそこ歩いてるあの人ですみたいな。へえ、じゃあもう正直あれですよね、ここの会社で終える気はないですよねとかって話をして、
はい、
あの転職考えてますとか。
そうですか。
どうしたらいいですかねみたいな話を僕は一人でこうフリーでその時はやってた時だったので、
はい、
生活とかできるんですかみたいな、
こういう気になりますよね、
こういう風にすれば大丈夫ですみたいな話をして、でもその方辞める時にメールくれましたからね。
そうなんですね。はあ、い、面白いですね。
面白いですね。まあでも店員さんとそこまで深い話になることはほぼないですけどね。たまにありますね、
私もいろんな方に話を聞いてみようかな。
ぜひぜひ、はい、本当面白いですね、人の話は。
そうですよね、はい、本当にもう一人一人いろんな人生がありますよね。
本当そう思います。
第90回お送りしてまいりました。さあ、この番組ではご質問ご感想を随時お待ちしています。メッセージは J さんのアメブロ英語モチベーションブースターの中のポッドキャスト下にお問い合わせフォームがありますので、お気軽にお送りください。そして来週の配信はお休みとなりますので、また2月にお会いしましょう。それでは J さん、
OK Thank you for listening. See you next week.
バイバイ。この番組は提供株式会社ラーニングコネクションズ プロデュースキクタス、ナレーション生きみえでお送りしました。